I, you know, of course, watched him play, and you know, thought he was tremendous. You know, just watching from afar, you know, would watch them on TV. And he was so big and athletic. You know, he had that combination. He was kind of all over the place, but he had skill. You know, he's my kind of player. I mean, I always love those kind of guys with that kind of length that play with that kind of energy and athleticism. You know, the way he impacted the game, it was amazing to watch. I mean, it, you know, sort of infected the rest of the team in a very positive way. You know, but I've told this story before, but you know, I went on the Nike trip. And, you know, we didn't get invited to that stuff a lot in those days when you're the little major coach. I was at Lehigh. So I was in St. Thomas and got paired up with Coach Davis at a dinner. And, you know, he's terrific, easy to talk to. And I knew who he was and know him. And he said, hey, you know, we just got this commitment from this young kid. And, you know, in those days, that was rare. And we took commitments from, he was a sophomore. I'm like, really? Wow. You know, we didn't even look at, we were just trying to get seniors to say yes. In those days, he said, yeah, I think the kid's going to be really good. Came to our camp, told me the whole story. And then so, you know, I made a point to watch him. And then, you know, I remember hearing that he was killed and saying, it's just awful. You know, I can't imagine, you know, as a parent getting that phone call, what it meant to the program at the time. They were playing so well. They had a really good team. And then I used to see Gary Close on the road a lot. And Gary and I became friends. And you know, we would talk about it. It really affected him. And I remember, you know, saying, you know, how's the family and stuff like that. And you know, I think Gary might be coming this weekend. I'm not sure. He came the last time. Of course, the last time we played Wisconsin, he was on the bench. But, you know, since I got here, I've gotten to know Mike and Patty really well. You know, the golf outing is something that I think is unique to our school in the sense that, you know, we fill up the morning session, the afternoon session, all of our players come back. And the commitment from, you know, businesses in the community that donate stuff for that event have been doing so for a long time. But obviously, endowed a scholarship in Chris's name. That was very important, I think, to the Street family. And they come back and play in the golf outing. You know, his sisters, and his uncle, obviously his dad. You know. But there's times, like I said before, when I'll just look up at the stands and there's Mike and Patty sitting there. They, you know, they come around a lot. And yeah, I went to a concert over at the State Fair, and you know, I know where they set up shop, so I go visit them, and you know, it means a lot to me, and it means a lot to our program and our players that they come every year to present the Chris Street Award, which you know is the most prestigious award that we give out at the end of each year. It's not necessarily to the best player; it's to the person that most exemplifies the qualities that Chris did. And, you know, it means a lot to our guys, and they know and understand that. So, you know, the fact that we're gonna honor his memory the way we are tomorrow, I think is very special and, you know, speaks to who we are as a program, as an institution. And I always use the word, you know, we're a family, and that's what you do. You know, you remember and you honor, and, you know, I think it'll be good for everybody involved.